weird philosophy, that weird theory, I don't know what the word is, but if the whole world, if we all used golf carts instead of regular cars, we'd be so much happier.
What, it would be more fun?
It'd be more fun. It would take you 10 hours to get home every day.
Like, where could you go?
Well, I mean, that's essentially what a Tesla is. You know, like an electric vehicle.
True.
It's the, you know, souped up.
But it's not open
golf
air.
Cart.
Yeah, it's open air. It's like
it's convertible.
There's no doors. Yeah. You know, like you could be at a stop sign. You could just see a friend and be like, "Hey, man, just hop on in." He just hops right in.
Sure, great.
And then you continue on your way.
Love it.
Well, there's like
it'd be fun.
There's like communities where they have
a lot of golf and retirement communities. Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I know. And why do you think they're all so happy? Because they're in golf carts.
Well, that's the type of community we're talking about.
I know. And I'm saying if the whole world was like one giant retirement community, we'd be happier.
Catalina
on account of the
Island,
golf carts.
Everybody's on golf carts.
And are they not happy there?
They do. They're ripping out.
See?
They're ripping out.
What else is in the news there, Seabass?
This?
breaking news, people ripping out on Catalina Island.
Oh, yay.
Yep,
on account of golf carts.
I'm just so much happier.
Yeah.
This is actually...
Yeah.
My joy is off the charts.
Catalina.
This is an interesting story, and I don't know if this sucks or it rules or a mixture of both. And it's actually gaining a nationwide attention out of Santa Ana.
It's just weird. Like, how does this happen?
Yeah, so this guy, he got a call that his son died a while ago.
Mm-hmm. Oh, this is crazy.
He's 82. His son, what he thought was 57. His son had a history of mental illness, on and off homelessness.
Right.
And they said, when they called this man in Santa Ana, they said, "We found your son dead behind a store. And we checked on the fingerprints, and it's definitely him, and we're sorry to, you know, tell you," and so on and so forth. So the older man, the 87-year-old, he went ahead, was like, "Okay, I know, you know, it's terrible, but it's not unexpected." Paid $20,000, had a funeral, about 50 relatives came in, it was a big deal. Then 11 days ago, he got a call that his son is still alive.
That weird?
Well, did he get a call from the son, and that's how he found out?
Exactly.
Well, somebody put the son on the phone.
Right.
And he said,
"My
Hi,
son
Dad,
is,
me.
You know, he's got mental issues." So... they're not sure how they misidentified the body. Again, they said they thought they had fingerprint match. Obviously, somebody screwed up somewhere.
So does he get his money back?
Right.
I know.
Right.
He spent, what, $20,000, you said?
Right.
Or they can just keep the money and just hold on to it for when it's, like, legit.
I know. Or just buy a golf cart or something.
I mean, and then they'll turn that frown into a smile.
Yeah, maybe that's what the son is missing his whole life.
Yeah. Just
the joy of a golf cart.
Just having a golf cart.
Yeah.
I'm so happy.
Yeah.
Well, driving my golf cart.
Walking on sunshine.
That is true. That golf carts are just adult power wheels, says the 661. That is absolutely true.
Well, Greg's totally convinced me. Golf cart coming at me.